Hello guys, today we are going to talk about the relay module known as KY019. This is the module itself. So, let's get started.
Today's video is brought to you by ORGVSN, an online store where you can find shirts, jeans and cool accessories that fit your needs. All the products are made in Italy. They can be shipped worldwide, so don't waste your time, start looking fancy today with their style. For more information, go to orgvsmshop.net or check it out at the link on the video description.
This module has integrated on board a relay, one LED, one resistor, one diode, and one transistor. The resistor used in this module is 150 ohm, and the main reason for using the resistor is to limit current circulating inside the module. The LED lights up to show if the module is working or not. Now I will show how these components are connected together. There we have the relay itself. And we can see the LED L1, the resistor R1, the transistor Q1, and of course, the diode D1. On the right you can see how the pins of the module are connected on this board. We have in red the flow of the voltage. We have in black the flow of the ground, and of course we have in green the flow of the signal. Relays are switches that open and close circuits electromechanically or electronically. Relays control one electrical circuit by opening and closing contacts in another circuit. As relay diagrams show, when a relay contact is normally open, there is an open contact when a relay is not energized. When a relay contact is normally closed, there is a closed contact when a relay is not energized. In either case, applying electrical current to the contact will change their state. Relays are generally used to switch smaller currents in the control circuit and do not usually control power-consuming devices. Nonetheless, relays can control larger voltages and amperes by having an amplifying effect, because a small voltage applied to a relay's coil can result in a large voltage being switched by the contacts. Let's talk about the pins. The pins in this module are three. We have the ground pin with a minus sign, the voltage pin is in the middle, and of course we have the pin of the signal with the S sign. So let's talk about the signal. This module takes a digital signal, so we can connect the pin of the signal with any digital port of different microcontroller boards like Arduino or Raspberry Pi. That's it guys for today. If you like the video, hit that like button. If you want more videos like this one, hit that subscribe button with a bell icon so you'll be notified for every video. We upload new videos every day, so the only chance to see them first is of course through subscription. Don't forget to check our social media and see you guys next time.